Hey, we're Blender Style, and we've been very bad boys. On this episode, Kitty, Spit, released in 2000 on NG Records. Cheers, gentlemen.
Cheers.
Cheers.
So I was always a big fan of Drain STH over Kitty, and there was like a constant, I mean, at least between our group, Kitty versus Drain argument going on.
Oh, yeah, I remember that.
As the years went on, you know, Drain STH kind of broke up and went wayside, and Kitty stuck around. So I figure with the Sig New World Festival coming up and Kitty kind of making a reunion, now would be a good time to kind of visit it and see what you guys thought.
I got a Kitty sampler CD that had a single on it. I think it was Brackish. Mm-hmm. And the first track, Spit, I think was on it too. And then I picked up on a couple other Kitty albums, like Funeral for Yesterday. I listened to that, but like I never paid attention to their other releases. But I have heard this album for sure.
Oh, for sure. Nathan, what about you?
Spit was the first track I ever heard.
Uh-huh.
And
did you hear it back in the day though?
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, probably maybe not as early as you guys, but mm-hmm. like when the girls at my high school caught on.
Oh like, yeah, dude.
Yeah, I like
it's one of the things I like about it.
Yeah, that's why I noticed. And the girl showed me the track Spit.
Okay.
And I was like, damn, this like is almost has like a. It's real, I don't know, it's groovy, it's
a weird mix of kind of like nu metal and kind of just metal at the time.
Mm-hmm.
It's kind of a weird blend. It doesn't necessarily hit all the way to like death metal, but it has kind of those underlying tones of that's where they wanted to be, but mm-hmm. they just weren't there yet.
That's true, because later they get heavier.
Yeah, because I think Oracle came out after this, that was too heavy for me. I never listened to it.
Mm.
And I think maybe just at the time it was too heavy for me, but I didn't get it.
I went back and listened to probably three Kitty albums, this one and the two after it. And it does get like heavier. Mm-hmm. And then Funeral for Yesterday is not heavy.
Yeah, I don't know what happened there.
But I did listen to that one. I like the title track, Funeral for Yesterday.
Yeah, that's a good track.
The rest of them's okay. This is... how old were they when they recorded this, dude?
So I don't know exactly how. I think it was recorded in 96, they said. So I don't know how old they were.
They're all girls. And
They were 14 years
supposedly
old.
Supposedly all the songs were written when they were 14. Yeah.
Okay. And they're girls growing up in Canada, Ontario.
Yeah, so it was Mercedes, the drummer,
mm-hmm.
and
Morgan.
Morgan, her sister. But I think it was Mercedes and Fallon that originally started the band.
Brought her sister in later.
Yeah, and then they brought their sister in later. And I couldn't find it when I was researching it, but I tend to remember back in the early 2000s when this was kind of a big thing. And, like, you know, my brother and all his friends, the Nailers, were adamant that Kitty was better than Drain STH, and we had this constant argument. I seem to remember holding it against them because the singer, Morgan, said that she wasn't really into metal at the time and she was kind of into Britney Spears and Christina Aguilera. I couldn't find the interview, so I don't know if maybe I'm just imagining this, that I rubbed it in their face. But there are some heavy, like, Britney Spears influential, like, vocal patterns going on in this. Like, on Johnny.
I got a comment. Because... honestly, these songs are kind of written like 14-year-olds. You know, they're like learning how to write songs and stuff. And it has like, it gets heavy. It like gets mellow. It gets, you know, there's singing parts.
Yeah, you can totally tell they're trying to find their way. At some points, it gets kind of cheesy.
There's a bongo that's played way too long.
Oh my god!
So like, you know, I could just imagine this, you know, 14-year-old girl being like, "Oh,
you don't like the bongo song? What is that, Paper Doll?"
Paper Doll is actually the one that I kind of liked the least on this.
Okay.
Really?
But I don't hate it. Like, these are like actually like enjoyable songs.
And that's my thing. So back in the day, I didn't like this because to me it was poser heavy.
Because when you're a kid, dude, you're like the biggest elitist asshole ever. Oh, fuck, you know, yeah, what I mean? True. But the fact that, you know, like, you know, that it's all females and they fucking were getting out there and kicking ass and like they're part of like they're, dude, Kitty's known, you know.
Oh, yeah.
You see, I see young kids now wearing a Kitty shirt. You're like,
well, and so that's my thing with it. So I think I was into Drain STH, but I think it's because
I don't know of this band.
Back in the day, they were way more polished. And then, you know, I don't know if they came out before Kitty. I think maybe they came out in 98, 96, somewhere around there, or their album did. And then Kitty came out and it was heavy. But it was very, to me, poser heavy, in the fact that they still hadn't found their sound and there wasn't that polish and stuff. I mean, Morgan does these growls, but her voice cracks throughout them and stuff.
Yeah, it's bad.
It's like the first year Erase album.
Yeah, it's bad.
I definitely hear Erase.
And it's good.
I hear Kitty.
So you think it's you're right, but it's because they look just like your little brother and all of his friends.
I like that this is very female.
Oh, yeah.
I like that they're not trying to hide that they're female. I like that it's...
Oh, I think that's way cool, too. You know what I mean? Yeah.
And,
absolutely agree.
When I was younger, I might have looked at it in, like, a dumb way. Because, you know, you're used to seeing, like, heavy-ass shit, dudes up there being hard as hell. And then you see a... You know, I don't want to sound like that, but maybe... But I'm just thinking that was my first impression. Like, oh, they probably aren't that good. They hear this one good song.
And well, that's the thing. In the early 2000s, there was a stigma of, like, if you're a female band, you're not going to be heavy. I mean, even bands who had a female, I mean, what, Cold Chamber in 2000 and, like, what, 2002?
Not that a female band couldn't be heavy or anything. It's just, like, it's very rare, right? Yeah. It's a rare thing.
Well,
so anytime anything is new to people, like, it's sometimes a little awkward and you're like... You know,
and
that's how it was for me with Kitty.
Yeah, I get it. So for me, this was kind of like posery at the time, and like I said, the argument was constantly there between me and my brothers and everybody, and all their friends.
So what do you their poser? Like, what do you mean?
Well, just because of that influence, like Johnny, that Valley girl accent that she has with Johnny's been a very bad boy.
Mm-hmm.
Like, it's very Britney Spears, Christina Aguilera. And to me, that influence came through really strong at the time.
I think she's very obviously being like, kind of like ridiculous with that.
Well, and that's the thing, as the music, as I came to like listen to it more and stuff, I think it was pretentious for the sense of like rubbing it in other people's faces and stuff. And so, as I listened to it more and stuff, it kind of grew on me. And then I was like, okay, well, maybe there is something there and they're really good. And then Oracle came out and I was like, fuck no.
No, she went like,
it was so
I read an interview. She said something like she started listening to Cannibal Corpse.
Dude, it was so heavy and I wasn't there yet. And my,
you can hear her trying to do it in this one.
Oh, for sure.
And it's like, she can't do it.
No.
It's like, I've been in bands that sound just like that. For real. They look just like that. A bunch of kids. I'm playing with,
I think also the recording kind of doesn't do it justice.
Oh,
I think
sure.
Also, like, you know, they probably didn't have a lot of money to do this, but this is a debut. Like, if this was, like, recorded, like, if they were able to do this on a laptop in their own bedrooms even, I feel like they could have made it even sound a little better.
I agree. Truth.
Not to shit on whoever did this recording.
But you can tell it's a budget-constrained recording.
Yeah. They want to do a lot of stuff. The music kind of gets heavy. It slows down. They're, like, doing different...
Yeah, and maybe adding different things to heavy music. Maybe it's just the producer, whoever produced them, just didn't understand how to capture that energy.
Or just, yeah.
The production's lazy because it feels like instead of doing the whole album, he just spent like all of his effort on doing the loops and shit on Brackish.
Yeah.
Which is awful, dude. It's bad.
It's so bad.
It sounds awkward and out of place every time I've heard it. I was like, what the fuck is going on? There's like extra drums or something.
Well, and so here's something
it's
else.
Bad.
Cheese is good, dude, but when the cheese is bad, like smelly cheese,
yeah,
that's
bad.
What's kind of on this.
Guitar player Fallon left after this album. And she went on to create her own, another band. I forget the name of it. But it's it has like a lot of samples and loops and stuff, and it's not really heavy from what I've heard. I didn't really get into it, but
interesting.
So I think that was a lot of her influence on that. And I think that's the other thing is like these girls all came together from different musical like backgrounds and styles and tried to just cram it all together. And at the time, nobody knew how to give and take. And so everything kind of got head on to each other and it just clashed. Not saying it's bad. It's just you could totally tell.
You can totally hear the adolescence in this.
Exactly.
Yeah. Well, you could tell that they're trying to just figure it out, right?
Oh, yeah.
They're just trying to figure everything out. And like, if they, who knows, if maybe they had another, if this album didn't like get, because it kind of got them pretty popular, you know what I mean? I think they sold some quite a few records and they were pretty popular and
played some festivals.
Yeah, if it maybe stayed a little smaller for a minute and they kind of like got to work it out, I feel like this, you know what I mean, like really find themselves. I think there's probably a lot of pressure probably on the next album, you know.
Dude, Morgan did guest vocals on a Cataclysm song.
She did.
Oh, really?
That's tight. It Turns to Rust, I think is the name of the song.
It was.
Which is from one of their albums I really, really like. Cataclysm is a dope death metal band from Canada. And she's on that song. I've been listening to that song for years, dude.
He just
I was like, no shit.
That's tight.
More, I've heard Kitty.
You're like, whoever sings this part is amazing. And you're like, oh shit.
I think they're like singing together on that part. Okay. It's like backup vocals.
So I have to say, like, my favorite thing about this album is the progression of listening to the Lander sisters.
Lander.
Their progression from where they came from, because like Morgan's vocals are sloppy, and I mean she's trying really hard, and even Mercedes' drumming on this is sloppy. Like
I think some of the drums kind of tight.
It's tight.
Oh no, her drumming's awesome.
Her drumming's tight. That's the highlight. Yeah, but I think the drumming's sloppy. Tight. There's in the fact, some... like her whips are somewhat off time on some parts. There's some really good.
I think it's good.
Tom fills and there. It's good,
dude. Like but... if maybe this was like not a mid grade recording. If this was recorded maybe rawer
and maybe or that's it.
More produced, I feel like it would have.
But
she's
like,
young. Yeah.
Yeah, but I feel like, and then comparing it to where she's at now, like on Funeral for Yesterday, or even Oracle for that matter.
Oh, she's
like, leaps and bounds. Like the vocal performance is 1,000 times.
This
better.
Is the only album the drum, I've ever listened to.
The drum
to
performance is 1,000 times better.
We gotta talk about Homegirl's drumming though.
Oh, dude.
Because she's on Drumeo, this drum like mm-hmm. online drum school that I spend some time on. And she did like she was like a guest teacher or whatever, okay. And she plays like a part. I think she played Funeral for Yesterday,
okay.
But they like stripped the vocals or whatever, and she plays live drums. Dude, she plays hard.
Is it the same drummer then?
Yeah, same girl.
That's tight.
She plays hard as fuck, dude, and she is a good drummer. And I
like
think,
that shit, dude.
No, and that's what I'm saying. Like from where this was this. To where they are now, like the progression is like. The most interesting part of this, I think.
Well, they probably played these songs better than they did then. You know.
Well,
what
and
I mean?
That's what I'm saying. Like,
that's probably true, dude.
They're so, probably like got to, this shit down.
To listen, like a lot of bands when they put out their first album, they're dialed in and they're tight and they know exactly where they're going to be, and they play it 20 years later and it sounds the same. They might change up a part or add something in there. This the progression on it from where they were at to when they play these songs now. It's like night and day, and it's so cool to see that. I commend them for putting it out there when they weren't quite ready. I mean, they did great and stuff, but I feel like they weren't quite ready at the time. And to hear the progression now, just that span, like in how
the
much
fact better, that they've been a band since what 1996?
Yeah, exactly.
Isn't it? It's like
they're the modern day Abbott Brothers. They really are
the Lander sisters.
Yeah.
Oh my god. I don't know, man. I really love some of the groove on this. I think the drumming is actually pretty good. The vocals are good. There's some parts where, like, yeah, I agree. Like, you know, she's just trying different stuff. She's doing dynamic in the music, and mm-hmm. like, I feel like. That's kind of what was going on at the time too. You know, you hear like Sepultura in this, you hear like,
there's a lot of influence in this album.
There's like low, the guitars are super low and chuggy.
And like, I don't know. I think it's a good mix of stuff. I think they did a really good job, but like the recording of it is where I'm kind of like,
yeah,
just have like some conflict on it.
So with that being said, what would you rate it then?
I rate this a 3.9.
Oh, damn.
Yeah. I have to be completely honest. I think this is the first time I've ever listened to this album in complete, like numerous times.
Okay.
You know, I've always dug it. I always respect it. And
you always kind of picked and choose songs off of it.
Yeah.
Okay.
And I actually really enjoyed listening to it. I give it a 3.9.
I kind of can't wait for you to go listen to their other stuff now since you said you haven't.
So I saw a documentary about them.
That's actually a really good years documentary. Years
ago, and yeah, I can't really remember. I wasn't as interested because maybe I wasn't like a big fan, you know? But like it was cool to hear the backstory and how young they were. Mm-hmm. Like, dude, anybody that's playing music at 14 years old and getting or starting to write music at 14, 16 years old,
and like, then, yeah.
I'm totally down, dude. They're musicians for life, and I mad respect.
And it's a weird perspective that you can't get all the time. Like, everyone's gone through, like, 1,000 breakups and whatnot, right? But mm-hmm. from a 14-year-old's perspective, it's, like, a weird glimpse into humanity. You know what I mean?
Yeah, fuck, dude. That's deep.
This album's not that deep, though.
No.
I give it a 3.1 out of 5.
Okay.
It's almost not good. There's a couple of like killer songs and then lots of duds for me. It's clear that just, you know, it's the beginning of the writing process and how learning how to write songs and stuff. You can,
I think that's why I love it, because you could hear that in it,
and that's why it's like not bad, because it's charming.
Yeah.
It's heavy. It's like, it's good. 3.1 out of 5 for me.
That's good.
Casey, your pick?
I gave it 3.8 out of 5. I feel like not being really into Kitty back in the day, and then them kind of growing on me over the years and stuff, and coming back to it, I'm with you. There's some duds on it and stuff. I'm also with Nathan. I feel like the recording quality on this is kind of what hinders it the most. I would love them to not remaster this album, but re-record this album.
With better pedals.
With better pedals.
You don't have to do necessarily, like, because some of the...
Yeah, I don't want them to...
In the pedal and some of the
So Monster Magnet came back and recorded...
Dude, let's not even
I just want to bring this up. They re-recorded Tractor, I think in 2000, from one of their previous albums. And they screwed it up because they didn't record it true to the original, just, you know, with their better abilities. They changed everything. And I think if they came back to this album, like if Kitty came back to this album and re-recorded it and kept it as true to the original, just like Nathan said, with better quality, I think it would, like, their abilities and stuff.
Dude, bands have done this for many, many years.
Can you imagine?
Only one band that has ever done this correctly, and that's Dimmu Borgir, Stormblast. You've
said this before.
And, dude, Hellhammer playing drums on it, dude, just ups it that much.
But I'm just saying, can you imagine Morgan doing vocals on the heavy parts on this with her ability now compared to
it would be
to
way cooler.
Does she do vocals like this anymore? Because when bands get like later, you see them and they're like trying to protect their voice and they're not off.
Suicidal Tendencies did Psycho.
Oh yeah, still Psycho.
That's better than the original.
I think so, 100%.
Yeah, there's another one. But usually it falls short, I agree.
We're Blender Style. This is Kitty. Spit. Let us know what you think. Leave a comment below. Leave an emoji. Give us a middle finger if you want.
Oh, spit.